Moff Gideon has arrived safely from GameStop, and he means more to the nerdery than you will ever know. But let's see where he ranks amongst my top 5 Black Series Imperial officers. As we go through the rankings, I'll show you where each Imperial is posed in their displays. Let me know in the comments below how you have these figures displayed. Director Krennic gave us some very memorable moments in Rogue One. The scene on Mustafar was so cool, but also showed us how his ambition outweighed his rational thought when he tried to press Lord Vader. And let's be honest, man, the white Imperial uniform paired with the black pants was exquisite on screen, man, and looks just as cool in a display with the other Rogue One figures. I really dig the face sculpt here. It looks like Ben Mendelsohn from side and front. And I really appreciate this pensive expression on his face. Kind of reminds me of the look he had on the scene where Tarkin put him in his place, and then he foolishly ran to Lord Vader for help. The hard rubber cape is prohibitive of movement, but if you like the aesthetic, it is a fair trade-off. It does look really cool like this. I can kind of picture him posed with the squadron of Death Troopers in the background. That's exactly how I have him posed in my display, man. They look so cool paired together, and then I also have a Scarif Trooper right off to the side behind him. Ultimately, he comes in 5th because he's the least intimidating Imperial on this list. Where does the movie Rogue One rank on your list? General Veers, Hero of the Empire, comes in at a begrudging 4th place. It is no slight to this figure, which is exceptional. Veers does come in the standard Imperial gray uniform, but gets this sweet force multiplier by this armor he wore in the AT-AT in Empire Strikes Back. Dude, he is so cool, man. I just can't even tell you how awesome it is to have him in a display. He immediately connects me back to the opening of Empire Strikes Back. Veers' face sculpt is spot on and looks perfect under this helmet. This is exceptional work for a supporting but very, very memorable character. I mean, seriously, how many characters in sagas like Star Wars that only have minimal screen time make you this happy when you see him in your display posed with other action figures? Let me know where Veers ranks on your Imperial officers list. Number 3 is Archive Wave Admiral Thrawn. Dude, do you hear those organs? I do every time I look at him. I was thrilled when he was announced as part of the Archive Wave, and so grateful I was able to get him early from GameStop. Thrawn's blue skin and red eyes stand out against the Imperial uniform. The gold bands on the shoulders, as well as the rankings on the collar, are a chef's kiss, and they pop under the LEDs in a display. I really appreciate the more realistic detail in his Imperial rankings versus Krennic. They're just a shade darker, and the silver behind them looks slightly weathered. I am really pleased with the face and hair sculpt. The raised eyebrow is a nice touch to honor the character's performance in Star Wars Rebels. I currently have him posed my Star Wars Rebel display next to Ezra Bridger. Adding Thrawn took the entire display to another level for me. How about you guys? Where do you have him set up in your display? Thrawn's intimidation factor for an Imperial officer is through the roof, man. All he has to do is speak with his arms like this behind his back, and you can feel it, can't you? Moff Gideon is the newest member of the Imperial nerdery and immediately moves to number 2 out of the box. The soft rubber shoulder armor moves with the arm, allowing full range of motion. Pinless elbow is better than 90 degrees. Also can touch his face. Excellent rotation at the waist with that sweet shiny armor. Thigh cut, and then the pinless knee joint at 90 degrees. You can appreciate how the post-Return of the Jedi Imperial uniform has been updated to all black, and the coat hangs much shorter, and the belt with the red outline is a sweet touch. Dude, look at all the detail running through that, man. That looks so cool under the LED lights and a display. I love the sheen of the armor, which definitely feels like an homage to Vader. And check out this face sculpt of Giancarlo Stanton. The mustache is on point and the expression is mildly displeased, but I'm interested in where all this is going. I like the aesthetics of the hard rubber cape, especially with the red lining. However, it doesn't stay on very well and it limits his posing ability, but it does look really cool how it hangs off his shoulders. So if you're okay with a more stoic stance, maybe holding something, man, I feel like I'm forgetting something. Man, what did I miss? Cape, the armor, face sculpt, articulations. Man, he's got an upgraded Imperial uniform. What is it? What am I missing about this figure? Clearly it's the Darksaber, and it absolutely lives up to the hype. Dude, it fits well in his hand. He has capability to dual wield it. Really appreciate the mold on it. It just looks so cool. And then the Darksaber itself, the blade, man. Check out how the clear white plastic picks up all the light from the LEDs And that black is just the perfect shade of matte black, man. It is awesome emanating out of the Darksaber hilt. He just looks so cool with that Darksaber, man. Let me know in the comments below how you have Moff Gideon posed in your display. Well, surprising, check out how he scales next to Thrawn, Veers, and Krennic. He definitely looks a good bit shorter than all of them, but still intimidating as heck with that Darksaber. Grand Moff Tarkin is still the GOAT of all Imperial officers. Peter Cushing was able to portray a character that was equally classy and menacing. The callousness and pure evil of Tarkin makes this character an all-timer for me. How about you? This is one of the better face and hair sculpts in the Black Series line. From multiple angles, man, it really encapsulates Peter Cushing and his performance. I mean, Tarkin, just posed like this with his arms behind his back and that stare with the eyebrow raised, is more intimidating than most Star Wars figures in any display. Honestly, man, how big of a bad you-know-what do you have to be to talk to Lord Vader the way he did? Comes in the standard gray Imperial uniform. It's a classic. He wears it well. And I love the way he looks in the LEDs under the display. The interrogation droid accessory is a must-have to be paired with a New Hope Princess Leia. I love the way it scales, and check out all the rich detail to it. That thing freaked me out when I was a kid, man. I was so scared for Leia, but it looks perfect in between her and Grand Moff Tarkin in my display. Ultimately, this figure is number one because Tarkin is the GOAT of Imperial officers, man. His ruthlessness and strategic mind were brilliantly executed by Peter Cushing, and this figure honors that, man. It takes me right back to the movie, and he really scared the poop out of me as a kid, man. How about you guys? Where does Tarkin rank on your list of Imperial officers? Please let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for hanging out in the nerdery and watching my top 5 Imperial officers. To me, they are all essential parts of the display. Each one is additive and helps complete the story from their respective movies or TV shows. Please let me know in the comments below which Imperial officers are your favorites and how you pose them in your display. Or do you keep them in box? Please like, subscribe, and ring the bell to join the noble quest of building this action figure collection. See you real soon.